Hey parents, thank you for joining us here at Beyond the Pew. Today we're going to be talking about the covenant that God made with Noah and his family. I'm sure most of you are familiar with the story of Noah, Noah and the Ark. So God comes to Noah, seeing that the rest of the world had been just kind of going to the pits. Like the rest of the world was just moving away from God and who God wanted them to be. And it says that Noah was righteous because he walked with God. So Noah is a righteous man trying to live his life and lead his family closer to God, a way that's separated from the way the rest of the world was living at that time. And so God invites Noah to build this ark so that he can bring about the salvation of Noah and his family and all the creatures throughout the world, because he's going to renew and restore this creation that he's built. And so Noah and his family, they build this ark, and he collects all these animals, and they go into the ark with him and his family, and God saves them from this massive flood, 40 days and 40 nights of just rain. So Noah goes in the ark with his family, and God saves them from the flood. It says he renews and restores the rest of the world. He washes out all the people that were not living a life according to his plan for them. So God saves Noah and his family. But I think a really important thing for us to keep in mind is, even though God asked Noah to build a physical ark, I think the more important ark that Noah was building for his family was the ark, like a spiritual ark. He was building a spiritual ark to protect his family from the ways of the world. So the rest of the world had been living this life of wickedness to the point that God had, to some degree, regretted what he had made when he created man. And so he wanted to renew and restore, and that's one of the beautiful reflections that we have in scripture of this time of 40 days. We have that in the Catholic Church during the seasons of Lent and during the seasons of Advent, where it's a time, these are both times of penance. We're invited back into relationship with God. We have this time of extended reflection to just spend away from the world and to renew our relationship with God. And so this is what Noah and his family are doing in the ark, is they're being renewed and restored. They're being separated from the ways of the world. There's this time of penance there, this time of washing away the wickedness of the world so that Noah and his family can be restored in God's image. And so God saves this family, and through them, he brings about this new world. It's almost as if God was restoring the original creation that he made. So in the beginning it says that there were these chaotic waters and that the Spirit of the Lord swept across the waters. And so again we see in the story of Noah that there's these chaotic waters that God brings about this new life, this new creation through. And that his Spirit was over the waters. Noah even sends out a dove, which is an image of the Spirit in the Bible, to go over the waters, and it brings back an olive branch, a symbol of new life. So Noah's family is an invitation for us to bring our family into relationship with God, to walk with God. So I don't know about you guys, but I don't think God's gonna ask you to build an ark for your family so that you can save them from a flood. But he is asking your family to build a spiritual ark. So how are you going to build that spiritual ark for your family? What's the mission of your family life? Do you have a family mission? That's their image of the Holy Spirit. The Lord is inviting us to reflect on the story of Noah and this covenant that he made with him and his family in our own family lives. The invitation for us as a family is to walk with God, to be an example of his love in the world. He's inviting us to create a spiritual ark to keep our families safe. How sturdy is your ark going to be?